Hello, everybody, and welcome back to Salted Hash. I'm your host, Steve Reagan, and today we're going to talk about fishing kit detection. So stick around. I've got something cool to show you. Welcome back. So before we get into the detection and the actual focus of today's video, I want to give you a little bit of background information. Over the last couple of months, I've released a number of videos where I show fishing kits from the perspective of the victim as well as the administrator. In each video, I've stated how important it is for administrators to detect these fishing kits as quickly as possible. And that's because as long as a kit exists on a system, the worse the problem is. But it's one thing for me to say that, to say, you know, you've got to detect these kits. It's another thing entirely for me to give you a tool which could help that process along. So with that said, today, for the first time, I'm going to show you a tool I've written called Kit Hunter. Kit Hunter is a basic Python script that's going to run on Linux, Mac, and Windows. As long as you can support Python, Kit Hunter is going to work for you. It searches web directories for kits based on common tag elements. Now, we've listed some very popular tags in the tag file that comes with the script. And what you see here, if we open that tag file, is common mechanics, script authors. They love to tag themselves in all of their work. So a lot of fishing kits usually have the author's name or special ways to identify and send out emails when they go out to themselves. You know, a lot of times they do branding, and you'll see that. And of course, we're also looking for security aspects. Fishing kits try to exist undetected for as long as possible, and they do so by blocking IP ranges and generating fake 403 or 404 pages if you access them directly, but you're not accessing them in the right way. A number of security elements, and we're looking for those. So, what we've got here in the lab is a fake website, and we've installed WordPress on it. Inside this WordPress installation are a number of phishing kits, and we need to detect them. So we're going to run Kit Hunter, and it's going to detect all of them. It takes a few seconds, and then that's it. When you open up the log, the actual report, you'll see a number of blocks. Now, each block is grouped by directory and then by file name, and every hit from a tag will generate a block. So let's go down to a big group down here so you can see the kit in its glory. What we've got is a number of hits in a number of directories. We see all the files that have been hit on, and the tag itself generating this block is GeoPlugin. The other element to this log file is the exact line of code where the tag happens to be. And what this does is it gives you at-a-glance context for the detection. It's one thing to detect a phishing kit quickly. It's another thing to add context so you can actually see what you're looking at. That's important. So here, we can look and see that in all of these directories and all of these files, GeoPlugin's being used, but what's it doing? When we stare at the line of code, we could see it's pulling somebody's IP address. When phishing kits are targeting people, one of the things they look at is where you're coming from and where you are currently. And this is how they sort their victims. GeoPlugin is just one way for them to do that, but it's easy to use. And it's really simple to pull things into a couple of passive arrays in PHP and dump them into email, and that's what they're doing here. So when you see stuff like this, that's a big giant red flag to investigate. But not only are you being given the warning that, hey, there's something in this directory, or hey, there's something in this file, and it's this, now you can see what it is. So after the script's ran and you're going to investigate, the sole purpose behind Kit Hunter, the reason I made it, is I wanted a way to detect phishing kits quicker on shared web hosting as well as dedicated web hosting. So that could be anywhere within your enterprise, or even if you're just running a dedicated server and you got permission to run your own Python instances. This video is being recorded about 3 weeks before the script is live. And as it stands now, the script works exactly as I want it to. It detects kits not only in the test samples that we've used, but brand new kits that were never included in testing. It's finding everything, which is exactly what I want. There was one instance of false positives, but we got rid of that and fixed it. Right now, everything it's detecting is spot on, which is good. Now, by the time you see this video, the script itself will be live. You can find it on my GitHub, which is github.com/stevedthree. Download it, try it out, let me know what you think. If you have any success stories and it finds something, tell me. Unless you give me permission, I won't write a story about it, but I would like to hear about the successes, the wins you're getting with this script. Also, if you think of a way that it could be improved upon, or if you have any suggestions, feel free to reach out to me and let me know. I want this script to be useful for everyone, and the only way that's going to happen is if we can improve it and make it better. As it stands, it works, and if it works, that's great. But I'm by no means a Python expert, so I know there's probably somewhere I can improve things. So please let me know. So, with that said, this has been your first introduction to Kit Hunter. I'm Steve Reagan, and this is Salted Hash. We'll see you next time. Take care now.